Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A very good afternoon to all my beloved student. Okay, kat luar hujan lebat. Okay, whatever this, we just try proceed with our discussion. So this afternoon, teacher would like to discuss with you regarding question with summary. Whatever we learn about chapter 4. Okay, so this afternoon, we try to solve one question. Okay, they are on, this is on page 76. Class, page 76. Okay, so the question start as to what is a sex link gene. Okay, so when you want to answer the question, gene. Okay, like teacher mentioned, one gene. Always a class, one gene equal to two alleles, am I right? Okay, so one gene always equal to two alleles. This is the concept that proposed by Mendel. Okay, in this case, it's a monohybrid cross. Right, so for sex chromosome, okay, for woman, okay, it will show XX, am I right? Right, and For men, it will show X, okay, and Y. Okay, so always remember class, one X, okay, how we inherit this X. If like teacher, like Risha, like Dashiga, Farah, okay, Kai, Nat, how we inherit this X? We inherit one from our father, one from our mother, paternal. Okay, like Shauki, Bihang, Dinesh, X automatically, Dinesh, you inherit from your mom, and Y, you inherit from your dad. Okay, from your dad, right? So this is the basic concept behind it, right? Okay, but for this case, okay, why this link gene, this gene, okay, like hemophilia, like normal vision, okay, normal blood clotting and normal color vision. Okay, this gene considered as a sex-linked gene. Okay, scientists has discovered, okay, the gene, okay, was found on the X chromosome, the sex chromosome X. Okay, so gene that carry on the sex chromosome ataupun link. Okay, when teacher mention link, link means something connected. Okay, kalau saya terangkai sex, gene terangkai sex or connected, or carried. Okay, this gene carried or linked together with the sex chromosome. Okay, because human female have two sex X chromosome. Okay, meaning like teacher, I have two sex link allele. Okay, this is what teacher mentioned. So that means teacher have two sex link allele. Okay, so big C. Okay, so I have two sex link allele, whereas in male the Y chromosome is smaller. Y chromosome is smaller, so the male only have one sex allele. Okay, so that means, okay, like Farid, you have only one allele, Farid, right? So now let's proceed discuss this question. Okay, given in the question, Peter married to Anita, right? And they have three kids, two boys and one girl, right? So the question asks you, what are possible genotype of Figure 3 shows, okay, controlled by allele. Okay, So Danish, your class, Danish is this one. Okay, what is possible genotype for Danish? Okay, so as you can see, okay, Danish, if you want to determine Danish genotype, so you have to see the patterns of inheritance. Okay, so Johnny is normal. So when Johnny is normal, Johnny, okay, carry dominant allele of H. And Y, okay, from her dad, David. Okay, her dad, David, eh? Okay, so when Johnny married to Danish, okay, Johnny will give Y to her boy. Am I right, class? So where this boy get his recessive allele? Of course, from her mom. Okay, so automatically her mom, okay, already carry one allele that passed to his son. Okay, so what is another allele here, class? Okay, jadi it can be carrier. So Danish can be big H, small H, or Danish also can be small H, small H. This is the answer for Danish. Eh? Okay, explain why? Because Danish has son with hemophilia. This one, class, eh? Okay, his son have hemophilia. Why? Because when boy or man, okay, the sex chromosome that he... Hello? Is it okay, hello, class? Teacher. You want to ask something?
Teacher tengah present screen ke teacher?
Ikram? Is it okay, Ikram?
Teacher tengah present screen ke teacher? Jawab tak ni.
Ha?
Cikgu ada present screen ke?
Ha? Ulang?
Cikgu ada present
screen ke?
Cikgu ada, ha?
Sebab kita orang tak nampak. Nampak muka cikgu je.
Okay.
Kita orang lost.
Kenapa tak cakap dari tadi, my dear?
Okay. Saya ada tadi lagi.
Alright, now can see.
Boleh, teacher.
Okay. Alright, so of course teacher share slide with you, right? Okay, class, okay, never mind. So, again, eh? Dah pening dah slide cikgu. Okay, never mind, teacher buka yang lain lah. Sekejap eh, kelas. Sekejap eh. Budi petang ni. This is what teacher mentioned just now class, eh? Okay, what's the sex link gene? Okay, what's the sex link gene? Okay, so this is what teacher mentioned just now, eh? Okay, so can you see my slide class?
Yes.
Boleh, teacher.
Okay, so this is what teacher mentioned just now. The question asks you what is the Danish, okay, Danish genotype. So this is Danish. Okay, wait there. Okay, so as you can see, Danish, okay, Danish, right? So how you know that Danish, genotype Danish? Okay, in order to know the genotype Danish, you see the his, her boy. Okay, her boy. Okay, so her boy is affected. Okay, so her boy is XY. Okay, this boy get Y from Johnny. Y, eh? From Johnny. So, of course, he will inherit the recessive allele. Okay, male with hemophilia. Male with hemophilia means, okay, he has H, okay? But the H is linked to the X, not linked to the X chromosome. Okay, so where this H is, received from her mom, because why is received from your dad, the class, eh? Okay, so then, so what is the possible genotype for Danish? So of course there are two possible. Either Janice is a carrier or Danish is a affected. And so that's why what dotted line like that. So that means Danish can be carrier, normal but carrier, okay, or she also can be affected. Okay, so explain your answer. Why? Because the presence of male, the presence of affected male son. Okay, that is the reason why. Eh, okay, that is the reason you answer for this question. Okay, so state the genotype for the following person: Henry and Peter, Okay, so what is the genotype for Henry and Peter? So, of course, Henry, as you all can see, a class is affected. So, why Peter will pass Y to Henry? So, Henry will hemophilia person. Okay, so Anita, of course, she is X, capital H, capital small H. And Peter is, okay, right plus, so Peter is X, XH, X capital H, Y for Peter. Okay, for Henry, because he is affected by hemophilia. Okay, so this is the answer. Okay, what is the Anita genotype? So Anita genotype is heterozygous, okay, or carrier. Okay, so give reason why Anita heterozygous, because the presence of Henry as a affected son. Okay, because of the presence of, because she has son with hemophilia named Henry, and normal son named Andrew. That is the answer that you give for this one. Because so hoping this question enhance your understanding about sex linked gene. Okay, so for the last before we stop the class, our class petang ni, okay, teacher would like to introduce you about the polygene. Okay, polygene, tengok page okay, on page 76 the class, question 6A. Okay, question 6A. Hello everyone, okay? Okay, turn to page 76, 6A. Explain polygenic inheritance. Okay, so when you ask to explain about the polygenic inheritance, okay, poly means many gene. Poly means mean, many, Okay, previously we learned multiple allele, but kali ni ialah polygene inheritance. Okay, so polygene shows many or two or more. Okay, more genes that controlling one trait. Is it okay? Is it okay, class? Farah, okay, Farah?
Okay.
Cik tak makan je, Farah. Okay, Farah. Okay, Mama.
Okay.
Alright, so polygene are many or two or more genes controlling one trait. So this is why they divert from what Mendel mentioned. Okay, divert, why class divert class? Okay, because Mendel said one gene equal to, okay, two alleles. But in this case, it involves more than one gene.
Cikgu. Kenapa double suara?
Anyone please Dinesh, unmute Dinesh. Dinesh, okay. Interrupt. Okay, sorry for that. Okay, back to the question just now. Okay, so the traits are quantitative. This is what you learn for variation in class, such as skin, color, height, weight. Okay, so the effect of gene. Sorry, teacher cannot erase this thing. I don't know why. Okay. You just ignore class, Okay, so each dominant allele contribute equally. Okay, so teacher have a one, I'll share you later, class, this one. Okay, so let's say if teacher give you the Punnett square here, right, why there's 64, class? Because, okay, there are four of, eight possible, Okay, eight gametes, 8 times 8, 64. Okay, it's 8 times 8 = 64. Okay, observation for Punnett square, where is actually 2 to the power of 3. Okay, possibility of gamut is 2 to the power of 3. Okay, so if you all do this, okay, you all kalau you all ada masa, you all boleh buat this one in class, Punnett square. Okay, and you can see the pattern of genetic inheritance. Okay, so paling dark having all dominant allele, this one paling dark class, so paling dark is dark, 1/64. Okay, dark skin heterozygous cross with dark skin heterozygous. So this pattern will when you draw Punnett square, you can see 64 possibilities. Okay, and out of the six, okay, class, number of dark skin allele paling banyak is intermediate. Okay, if you refer to our notes on page, refer to our notes, class, on page 80. Okay, you refer to our note on page 80. Okay, so you can label the class, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so 0 means extremely light. 6 means extremely dark. This one is extremely light. This one is extremely dark. And number 3, yang paling banyak is 20/64 is paling intermediate. Okay, number 3, intermediate. Okay, so this is a polygene. Okay, back the polygene just now, the concept of polygene. Okay, the polygene means, right, only dominant allele contribute. Okay, and only dominant allele contribute. Okay, and each dominant allele contribute equally. Okay, macam nak sama macam multiple allele. Macam sama tipe allele, tapi in this case it involve gene. Okay, so in this case there are 3 genes. That's why 3 genes. How many allele, class? Hello, class. 3 genes. That means
6 allele.
Okay, when you see the pattern here, every individual. Okay, there are 3 genes. Kalau human blood group, dia ada 1 gene, but multiple allele. But in this case, dia ada banyak gene. Okay, banyak gene. That's why you call it the polygene. Okay, so that's why you akan nampak all sorts of difference. Okay, so that's why for polygene actually, you are going to learn nanti, it contribute to variation in term of this bell shape. Okay, continuous variation. Continuous variation, and it will, if you plot the graph, okay, you will see the bell shape. Okay, let's say height. Okay, y-axis height against. Height against apa, class? Number of person. So, you akan dapat pattern dia like this. So, light, extremely light, extremely dark. Okay, tengah-tengah sekali, you akan dapat apa, class? Intermediate. Okay, so there are 6, 6 bar. Okay, there are 6 bar. Extremely light. Okay, 1, and then, tengok data tadi, class. This one, class, tengok sini. Okay, so extremely light. 1. After that, number 2 is very light. Okay, you get 6. Okay, and then 15. And then 20. After that, 6 balik. After that, 1. So that this is what we call as a bell shape. Okay, variation, continuous variation. So you're going to learn this topic next time, continuous variation. Okay, so I think it's almost 4 o'clock already. So teacher, stop until here. Consider we have done Okay, we have done chapter 4 class, eh? Yeah, yeah, okay. So, alright. Petang ni teacher... Okay, teacher consider we have done chapter 4. Okay, tomorrow morning, we are going to start with our new topic, that is chapter 5. Shauky nak cakap apa-apa ke? Ikram, why you are on hold, huh? Okay, so everyone, boleh kelas eh? So, jadi that's all okay. For our class. Okay, Jana, okay, thank you. Alright, so that's all for our class this afternoon. So, we meet again with chapter 5 tomorrow morning. Okay, so teacher nak you ready eh? question. Okay, ready question on page chapter 5, page... Eighty-nine, question 4, UPS 2010-2011. Okay, we are going to do that, eh? We are going to discuss that, and also page 90, okay, 2013-2014. Okay, ready that question, so that tomorrow we can discuss. Okay, class, so till then, we meet again tomorrow morning, okay? Bye, everybody. Bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher.
Bye-bye, teacher. Thank you.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher.